So I've got this little bit of aluminium. I'm going to build a plug for a through deck fitting. Just a short offcut from eBay. So let's go and fit it into the lathe. I'll just get ahead and machine it. Just getting into the job now. We're just giving it a bit of a shoulder there. Pretty much what I want over here. I've done this bit of the shaft and now I'm going to cut a concave along here to make a funnel shape. Okay, there we are. Not the most brilliant machining, but lovely anyway, nice and smooth. The radius here gives like a 5x radius for a 6mm piece of Dyneema. And by doing that, we reduce the compression on the rope. So that's the reason we've got like this cone opening on it. I can use this now to build. So we're going to polish this up and then we'll be able to release off it. We've got our little tool that we made. It's an offcut made to make this insert, which is going to go into the deck. It just bolts together with this bolt down the middle, hoping that we'll be able to take this piece off. I haven't put any release on it yet. The material I'm thinking about using is a Diolen, which is a polyester fabric, very good at abrasion. It's not that great to work with. Then over this bit, we're going to use a bit of carbon tube. We're going to check this goes into the bag nicely. Bit sharp there, so I've just got a nut protector to protect it. Roll it up a bit and give it a bit of a suck. Pull it in pretty well all the way around. And really, we're just vacuum consolidating it so that it's held into position and most of the air is taken out of the laminate. Okay, so here we are. We're going to give the prototype a go. Put some resin on here. I don't really want to go right to the edge. It's always quite hard to wet out totally. I realized my arm was right where the camera wants to be. You get this really thoroughly wetted out around the edge. We don't really need very big bits of tubular. The deck's not super thick. Well, wait a second, nearly forgot the old bit of resin on the sidewall. I'm gonna just get a load of resin into here because we really want the inside of the tube to be quite nice. This is a bit of carbon now. Cut ourselves another bit of tube. Get some more resin on there. We don't know how it's going to turn out. So I'm just going to put that on, a bit of peel ply. We could put some breather to reduce it, but I think on this one I'm just trying to vacuum consolidate it, so I'm not going for a massive bag to reduce the amount of resin. Put our little bit of plastic on the top there. Get our airline. Press down pretty well. So just have to get something to help release that. So I've got that a little bit bigger diameter. So there, it's come off. There's a bit of an edge here. I might put a bit of wax around there on the next one. But overall, that's pretty smooth and it's the hard wearing plasticky finish there. I'm going to just briefly sand that off very gently. Okay, the problem that you have with the Diolen is that you end up with a bit of a feathery edge, but obviously this gives the nice radius. Basically, it's a nice little neat molding. Okay, so I'm going to take it away and sand it. You can see where the bag's pinched it a bit. And there we are. Doesn't look like major voids in there or anything that you'd be terribly worried about. I mean, that's a pretty tough little molding. It's so simple. You're just going to put it through the deck. It's a lot lighter than aluminium. You just push the rope up through and you have your diamond knot on the bottom. So what we're going to do is make up some laminated plate that spreads the load of the knot out into the surrounding area. And although you've got a hole through the boat, it takes the load much better. We're getting a good radius so the rope's not unduly stressed. Nice and flush on the deck, and that's the idea behind them. Okay, this is our first prototype. We had the Diolen inside here, and as you can see when you cut the Diolen, it's like Kevlar and everything. It's a real pain in the neck and you think, well, do we really need to use it in this application? To sort of spruce this up, we've experimented with putting some graphite powder and epoxy mix on there. So for the Mark II, we're going to coat this with a graphite
and epoxy mix first. Once we've got it off, we're not going to have the problem with this edge, because obviously the carbon and everything's going to cut better. I've used this on the cars that go up and down the master track. They've worn pretty well, and the good thing about it is that you could recoat it if you start seeing areas of high wear.
So here's the tool prepared. It's got a bit of wax around there to the joint. I've got some graphite filled epoxy. This is going to be like effectively a gel coat. Takes a little while to do. Make sure we get a nice coating over the whole thing. We leave this to go a bit tacky before we put the next layer on top. Okay, it's a bit rough and spiky, but it doesn't matter because this is still going to be soft, and we're going to smooth it out as we put the cloth on and brush on the resin.
And basically you're just going to get a load of resin on. Got a bit of carbon, we've cut a little hole in the middle, and we're just going to poke it down. The reason these bits are a bit bigger is that if you cut them too small, they just it becomes an absolute nightmare. They fall apart. It's different if it's pre-preg, because it's sort of bonded together by the resin. You know, if you're doing it in your backyard, you can use pre-preg. You've got to have a fridge and all that sort of stuff. It's pretty damn good stuff. You just open them up so that they're nice and wide, so that when you poke them on, you're not getting any of the fibers buckled, which creates a void. And it's not particularly vital with this little component, because it's not that important structurally. Bit more angle on it, slightly different angle this time. And I'm just using sort of leftovers that I had lying on a roll just to make this component. So I'm gonna put that bit on.
Okay, you can see it's pulled down nicely. It's quite cool in the workshop, so I just blow the heat around. It's not sort of direct heat, it's not sort of super hot on it. We're not trying to make some high performance component, we're just making an eye for a rope to go through in the deck. We'll come back in a little while and just see how it's done. Okay, it is the finished bit. I separated it off. Looks like a pretty good finish on the inside there. Here we are, the component. It's cut off with a hole saw and just tidied up. It's a neat little deck fitting. It's probably a lot lighter than the aluminium equivalent. The thing about these fittings is they don't get a sawing action, so the rope going through is not getting pulled under high load in and out, whereas this composite fitting would probably suffer a lot of wear and tear that way. Because it's a fairly static load on the end of this is probably perfectly adequate. Putting the graphite powder, it's very slippery, so it's very good for a nice smooth finish if you want to run a rope around something and not get a lot of abrasion on it.